But here's the thing. Back then, I didn't know what steroids really did for you. I really had no idea. So I kind of like, oh, you know, it's part of the game. I didn't really even knew if that stuff really worked. Mm-hmm. So I just kept using it. Now, that same year, 85, coming to the big leagues, hit a couple monsters. One was, and I have my phone, I can actually show you guys if I get it from search. It was monstrous. It was at least 600 feet. And I'll show you guys, you're gonna go, holy shit. And they were kind of looking at me like kind of funny. How can a, and I was only 210 pounds. How can a skinny kid have ball that far? Then of course, the rest is history.
You run a 4340.
4.2940.
Yeah. Sorry.
But that was later on. That was when I actually, see, people don't know this about me, but in the 86 season, I think I stole 15 bases, got thrown out four times. The 87 season, I think I stole 15 or 16 bases, got thrown out three or four more times. Now, pre-88 season, I went to University of Miami and started working with sprinting technicians on how to become faster, on how to accelerate that first step, because I was tall and heavy, how to put on the right muscle mass in my legs to become a world-class sprinter. So that they actually taught me how to run. I worked with them for like 3 months straight. No one really knew this about me. So now I come into camp and my legs, my running muscles are more developed. I've got a lot more spring in my first step, even though now I weigh 230. Mm. But I knew something that Mita didn't know. That I have world-class speed at that time. Nobody really knew that. I used to run against the sprinters at the University of Miami and destroy them. They'd be like, holy shit, I should just blow them out of the water. So then I go into camp and they ask me, Jose, so what do you want to do this year? I mean, you've done 3,900. I said, well, I worked hard during the off season. I'm going to do the 40-40. They broke down laughing in my face.